So let's say you have a little bit of numbness and tingling in these fingers and half of this finger, and you sort of let it go. You don't think too much about it. And it comes and goes, so you really think it's nothing. And then you start getting this more frequently. And then maybe you start waking up at 4 o'clock in the morning with numb hands, and you really can't figure it out. So these are signs of carpal tunnel syndrome. And one of the questions that concerns me is, what happens if you don't treat carpal tunnel syndrome early? Here to answer this question is our chief medical expert, Dr. Robert Markison. Click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you'll know when new videos are posted. Welcome back, Dr. Markison.
Thank you very much. Always a joy to be with you.
Joy to have you. So what can you tell our viewers about neglecting to address the issues of carpal tunnel syndrome early? And I'm not intending to blame anybody, because these symptoms are not being broadcast over some public service announcement as they do for COVID and other sorts of big diseases. So people may not even know that they're, you know, they just think they're having weird symptoms.
Well, you were very accurate in describing numbness, tingling, thumb, index, middle, half of the ring finger. That's the distribution of the median nerve, which runs like a median strip on a highway down the middle and serves not only feeling, but also muscle activity in the thumb, and also little muscles that regulate movement of the index and long fingers. And so you may wake up wee hours, shake it a little bit, maybe it goes away, but if it persists into the daytime, then you might consider getting a medical opinion as to whether it's something that's actionable or may not require a little nighttime splinting and just live with it. But if it goes on too long, the concern is axonal damage. And so the conducting fibers of the axons and the insulator.
Wait a minute. Can you describe axons for people who may not know what they are?
Sure. Sure. An axon, if you have a copper wire and you have some plastic insulation on it to make it conduct, that's myelin, the insulator. But the business part of it is the little copper or axon. So copper in a wire, axons in a nerve conducting signals, which are both for feeling, sensory, and for movement, motor. And so if you get into some weakness, or worse yet, some atrophy of the thumb muscle, that's a sign that you need to act quickly, get an expert opinion, probably nerve conduction studies, maybe ultrasonography to look at the nerve, and then see a specialist who can take care of it. But if it goes on too long, you can permanently lose feeling, and you can permanently lose muscle, and it's not easily retrievable or reversible.
You know, years ago, I saw someone who had lost most of the thenar eminence, this big muscle wad in the thumb. And his thumb basically had caved in there. There was no muscle there at all.
That's right. You might be able to restore a fair amount of sensation with a carpal tunnel release, but there's no guarantee about restoring muscle function, because within about 12 to 18 months of no signal going through a nerve muscle, neuromuscular junction, those motor end plates, those little joint areas, waste away irretrievably. And so even with a proper release, you can't guarantee much in the way of return of muscle once atrophied.
And a lot of people tell me they have problems finding doctors who are capable of really diagnosing them. So can you give us a little guidance over what kind of doctor to see, what the doctor is saying sounds right, you know, so that people have some sort of sense of, gee, maybe I should get a second opinion here?
I think it's a good idea to start with your primary care physician. And there are many able nurse practitioners who can diagnose it as well. But see a medical person as the first contact. Subsequently, you may want to go to either physical medicine and rehab specialist, or perhaps to a hand surgeon who's not so quick to jump into the operating room with you. And so a cautious, careful hand surgeon who will first try non-operative, also known as conservative remedies.
Excellent. And is there any sort of physical therapy that can be useful? Can acupuncture or other treatments be helpful in calming the nerve and protecting the axon?
Sometimes, especially the supervision given by a hand therapist who's well-schooled in what not to do, what to do, splinting at nighttime, little home program, that can be helpful, not for everyone, but the first step would probably be off the shelf nighttime carpal tunnel splints to be worn at nighttime only, not during the day.
And one more question. You said things not to do. What should people avoid doing?
Well, the provocatives are wrist flexion, which tightens up the carpal tunnel contents, unnecessary wrist flexion, unnecessary wrist hand loading, extension. These are things that can tighten the tunnel. The guitarists I see who are flexing their wrist at the same time they're fretting on the fingerboard, that's combined trouble. And anatomy's destiny. And so nobody can guarantee that it's only tendons, 9 of them, going through the tunnel back and forth in company with the nerve, because you can have prolonged muscle bellies that enter the tunnel and dynamically crowd it. Similarly, from the far to near side, you could have little muscles in the hand that crowd it with a tight fist, wrist, kind of constant gripping sort of things. And then you realize that if you're doing too much hands-on typing without access to voice recognition software, you're tempting the fates a bit, because 9 tendons moving back and forth in company with the nerve can irritate it. Not in everybody, but it happens, and especially in the new era of remote work.
So I'm hearing you saying keep the wrist in a neutral position, which allows the nerve to flow freely without cramping it one way or the other.
Well, right. By position of function, it's about 15 degrees of extension, meaning this is extension, and then a nice relaxed position of the thumb and fingers. When you're like this, you may be crowding your tunnels. When you're like this, you could be crowding them from the other direction. In either case, you can be tightening up against the nerve, which is the kind of the odd person out in terms of vulnerability.
Thank you, Dr. Markison, for clearing this up. And I hope everybody stays tuned, because we're going to be talking about some other things that people think are helpful to their hands, but may not be so helpful. So thank you again for coming, Dr. Markison.
Sure.